equations have shapes. I think one of the most interesting aspects of mathematics is the relation between the algebraic properties of an equation and the geometric shapes it generates. A second degree equation makes a parabola, so it can have at most two real roots. It's useful in drawing planets, where each pixel is the solution of a different quadratic equation. A cubic polynomial can have one of three shapes. The degree of a polynomial shows how many wiggles the curve can have. And if you really want wiggles, look at a sine curve, a sort of infinite degree polynomial. But the sine is best known as the ratio of sides of a right triangle, or as the vertical position of a point on a circle. The symmetry of the curve shows some algebraic trigonometric identities. Translational symmetry of the sine wave gives rotational symmetry of the circle. And mirror symmetry of the circle is mirror symmetry of the wave. Another mirror symmetry goes diagonally on the circle. This gives the sine of the complement of an angle, the cosine. The cosine has its own translational symmetry. Sine waves are used to analyze sound waves, where you can build up complex waves either mathematically or with parts of your body. Remember the Pythagorean theorem? For a right triangle, the square on the hypotenuse equals the sum of the squares on the other sides. But if it's not a right triangle, this is no longer true. How can we fix it? The green and blue areas no longer fill the small squares. But here's something neat. The two leftover rectangles are also equal. And this works for any shaped triangle. Now, algebraically, the leftover areas are AB cosine C and BA cosine C. So we have A squared plus B squared minus 2AB cosine C equals C squared, the law of cosines. This is useful to measure distances that are otherwise inaccessible. The relation between algebra and geometry is a sort of metaphor for right brain and left brain type of thinking. To really understand the universe, you have to put both halves of your brain together. And what field does this best? Computer graphics, of course.
Braun introduces Flex Control, the first electric shaver with a pivoting head. Flex Control automatically adjusts to every contour of your face. Under the chin, under the lip, that tricky spot under your nose. You'll get the closest Braun shave yet. Flex Control from Braun, the last word in shavers.
2 and a half pounds, but I'm still the best damn lady you've ever had.
Oh, don't think fat. Don't even talk about fat.
Oh, please, girl, you look so good.
I heard you had a small bit. Did you hear it?
Thank you. Bartender, you know, the first draft beers really haven't evolved. But now there's new Golden Draft from Michelob. It's the only draft beer cold filtered and cold finished. The Michelob way. Thank you. So you get a smoother taste that makes ordinary draft beers seem like a rough draft. Knowing that, wouldn't you rather be holding the golden?
Excuse me, I'll have what he's having.
Here is the crystal structure of the self-complementary decamer, C-G-A-T-T-A-A-T-C-G. When we include the immediate neighbors, Their presence obscures structural features as well as crystal packing contacts. Using volume rendering, we replace the space-filling model with a molecular surface. The transparent surface of the neighboring molecules reveals the central molecule within. Now, information is added to the image by mapping crystal packing contact information onto the molecular surface according to the proximity of neighboring molecules. The map is colored green where the intermolecular distances are zero. The color gradually changes from green to yellow to red as the distance to the neighboring molecular surface lengthens from 0 to 4.5 angstroms. The color goes from green to cyan to blue for the same contact range on the central molecule. The contact information coded on the volume rendered surface reveals the cause of the widened minor groove. The backbone of the neighboring DNA column is wedged into the groove, holding it open.
The following program will contain no dinosaurs. It is, in fact, excerpts from the technical papers. The Institute for Strange Skin Diseases presents the technique to uniformly spread textures over arbitrary surfaces. Notice how the texture elements stay roughly square as the surface stretches. This paper shows the latest research in strange blobby objects. This paper shows that centrifugal force is really due to roundoff error. And when you get rid of the error, you get round. This paper shows a zoom through multiple levels of resolution to show hierarchical data. And we see that the universe is really made up of microscopic text particles. Here's a fast, interactive way to place 3D handles on various viewing parameters. It shows how to make a normal house change into a Toontown house. Society for Molecular Gymnastics brings us Molecules on Parallel Bars. They use it to design patterns for a molecular database search. This one uses force feedback with a scanning tunneling microscope to actually feel and move individual atoms on a surface. So you can build up circuits of the future atom by atom. Here's a modern form of cave painting, where field sequential stereo images are projected on the floor as well as the walls and ceiling of the cave. This one simulates atmospheric effects of the Earth as seen from orbit. Here we pick the best choice of displacement maps, bump maps, and reflection functions to make skin-like surfaces. I bet you thought this was going to be a dinosaur. This shows how to walk through a house when you can't see where you're going because this big yellow square blocking off your view. Here's a way to visualize vector fields by blurring along the flow lines. It shows the Earth growing gray hair because of all the bad things we're doing to it. This shows morphing between four views to get intermediate views for people who never get out of their chair. Here's a new type of stereo pair where the left eye is aliased and the right eye is anti-aliased with a technique based on frame coherence. A technique for removing color from images using dot diffusion along space-filling curves. Notice the squishiness of the grapes on the chocolate bar, the result of correct modeling of contact between blobs. This one uses neural nets to optimize locomotion. The two triangles have a nervous breakdown and commit suicide. This one uses a massively parallel genetic algorithm over behavior parameter space. Research is sponsored by the Ministry of Silly Walks. Here we simulate development of a hawkweed flower. Next year, ask them to simulate how to blow the fluff off. Computer graphicists still like to play in sandboxes. Here we simulate soil slippage using conservation of volume. And this paper shows that, no matter how complex a computer simulation becomes, it must always contain a sphere. So, don't forget to check out the technical program. That is, after all, why Siggraph was started.
Meet Franz K. He is a man caught in the self-denying act of creation. He has internal struggles he is powerless to quell. Conflicts of his identity, his relationships with the world, rage in his head and his gut without his approval, his control, or his awareness. To balance himself against this wrenching struggle, he tries to project his conflicts into the world through his artistic inventions, his inventive artisms, his retentive inversions, arventive incisions. He is treading lightly on a razor's edge of self-affirmation, but cannot laugh at its dullness. Like me, he is trying to share part of himself with his world. Like me, he is trying to cast himself as a martyr to unsuspecting tormentors. He is engaged in creating an unbroken self-portrait.
I am not responsible for this.
Like me, he does not know whether to love or hate his creation. Do you, Franz?
I don't know, Franz. You tell me.
What? My name is Scratch C. I'm a plague with a PhD. Not renewing the earth is my psychology. I'm bopping while I'm chopping, and I'm pouring all the stocking in the air, the soil and the sea. I make the soil worthless, and I boil the seeds with my logging and my mining and my CFCs. I'm gonna till it and fill it and practically kill it through my plan. You kids will be earthless, 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 earthless. A world of tropical moisture with Juju Shampoo. Welcome to the jungle. Juju Shampoo, scientific care for superstitious hair.
Thank you. We got a bug, my man. Yeah, I think that's some kind of job.
How are you feeling since your operation, my
brother? Bad, but I'm getting a few chest pains that I didn't have before the operation.
It looks like scissors or something, like, you know, like a clamp.
Well, let's not tell it. We'll move over to the technical now.
I'm talking about the breakdown of the whole system. The military defending people against people. You won't get your appropriations waving. That flag does no glory in that kind of warfare.
How can you possibly justify that one stealth bomber costs more than the government spends on cancer research in the whole of the United States of America?
But 1 million little planes.
$5,000 a piece, you see what I'm saying?
All I'm trying to say is calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down! Don't tell me to calm down!
Thank you. First, in the first place to begin with, secondly in the second place, lastly, again also in the next place once more, moreover, furthermore, likewise, besides, similarly, for example, for instance, another. Then nevertheless still, however, at the same time, yet in spite of that, on the other hand, on the contrary. Certainly, surely, doubtless, indeed, perhaps, possibly, probably, anyway. In all probability, in all likelihood, at all events, in any case. Therefore, consequently, accordingly, thus as a result, in consequence of this, as might be expected, the foregoing, the preceding, as previously mentioned, as already stated.
Imagine the condition of people living in a chamber underground with an entrance open to the light and a long passage all down the cave. Here they have been prisoners from childhood, not moving and seeing only what is in front of them. Now behind them there is a fire burning, and between the prisoners and the fire is a walkway with a parapet. Imagine persons behind this parapet carrying various artificial objects, such that the prisoners see nothing except the shadows thrown by the firelight on the wall of the cave facing them. In every way, then, such prisoners would recognize as reality nothing but the shadows of those objects. Suppose one of them suddenly decided to stand up, turn his head, and walk with eyes lifted toward the cave entrance light. And as he came out into the light, he was blinded by its radiance. But as his eyes grew accustomed to the light, he came to see the shadows of things and the things which cast the shadows. And he knew that that which he had previously believed as reality was an illusion. Then he called to mind his fellow prisoners and what passed for truth in the cave, and he asked, "What then should I do?"
Thank you. Thank you.